Good job. The barrier collapsed.
Only around the temple. How are we going to get a hold of the sleeper amulet?
That seems to be a problem indeed. The Grand Masters are split over it, but it seems as if each of them came up with a possible solution. You'd better speak with them yourself.
Greetings.
Can you remove the barrier?
Yes. A few days ago, I found this in the shattered remnants of a wall.
What's this?
Meteoric ore. In such a small lump, there's as much mana stored as in a head-high heap of magical ore. I carried out some research. Apparently, a star burst when the strong earthquake took place. The star's splinters rained down over the city. A few more lumps, and...
How many of those lumps do you need?
All we can get. According to my calculations, there should be at least 7 more in the city.
Do you happen to know where to find these lumps?
I do. According to eyewitnesses, one lump fell into the fortress. Another one hit the slums, where you activated the obelisks for Ningal. 2 others lie somewhere in the harbor quarter. And not far from here, in the temple district, 3 lumps were supposed to have landed.
How are we going to get a hold of the sleeper amulet?
The high mages of the temple did a good job. To remove this barrier, we'll need an enormous amount of mana. We'll practically need to entour the barrier under magical ore. But until enough ore from Corinus arrives, weeks or even months might pass.
Damn it!
I have another solution, though. In the catacombs, I discovered a hidden mana rune. Following my intuition, I detached it from its setting, and now the barrier is weaker than before.
So we need to remove the other runes to cause the barrier to collapse?
That's right. Each removed rune releases the next one. We could break up the barrier piece by piece.
Where are the other runes?
Presumably hidden far out in the city. However, I was able to gain an insight into the residual of the last century input of the mages who designed the runes. If we create a mental connection, I'd be able to lead you from one rune to the next.
How many runes are we talking about?
The potency of the runes should increase exponentially, so I expect 3 more runes at the maximum.
Where's the next rune?
When I took the first rune, the following reverberation reached me. Wind in my hair, smell of salt. I'm out of breath and feel a little dizzy. Behind me, blazing heat.
So that's what the mage sensed when he designed the second rune?
Yes, he did. Perhaps you can deduce the rune's location from that.
I'm rather busy.
Duranis said you have an idea how to get a hold of the sleeper amulet. I'm all ears.
We could blast the barrier.
Using what?
While you were killing the false believers, a blue-skinned harpy attacked me.
And on bail. Druhang's death must have made Zisha insecure.
On bail? Interesting. In any case, the power of my lord was strong in her, but I was stronger. Sucking her out was quite energetic.
What does that have to do with the barrier?
This barrier was created by the Sheep of Innos. If we flood it with my lord's dark power, it will break it.
What do you want to do? Sacrifice on bail on the barrier?
Their hearts should be enough. In that exquisite moment of death, the gathering of...
Thank you. I don't want to know the rest. How many hearts do you need?
I can sense another 5 on bail. In the city. In the harbor. Wealthy quarter. Arena quarter. Slums and... in the temple district. That should do it.
One thing confuses me. Shouldn't you be on the cultist side?
That question again? No, I'm on my own side, and my master's side. Those cultists are misguided.
Misguided?
Their view of Beliar is simplistic. My master stands for far more than indiscriminate destruction. They are heretics and must die.
They're coming!
Mercenary?
What a ruffian!
Whoever is still out there, get lost!
I heard something at the door!
How is Roba? What do you want?
The hearts. Give them to me.
Here are the hearts.
At last, I've prepared everything. The barrier will fall in a heartbeat.